The main idea of the active record pattern is to let the entity object encapsulate the data and the database operations you can perform on it. That makes it an excellent fit for the persistence layer of a Java application. Panache, a Quarkus extension based on Hibernate, provides great support for this pattern and makes it easy to apply to your JPA entity classes. Hi, I'm Torben Janssen. Welcome to the third part of my series about building efficient persistence layers with Quarkus. If you're new here and want to learn how to build incredible efficient persistence layers with Hibernate and Spring and all types of other Java persistence-related stuff, subscribe and click the bell to get new videos every week. And also don't forget to like this video if you found it helpful. In the last video of this series, I gave you a general introduction to Panache. I recommend you watch that video first. You will find it here and in the video description. Okay, let's take a closer look at the active record pattern. Martin Fowler describes the pattern as follows. An object that wraps a row in a database table or view, encapsulates the database access, and adds domain logic on that data. You probably already recognize the difference between the active record pattern and the usual approach to design and work with your entity classes. When working with plain JPA, Hibernate, or Spring Data JPA, we usually use the repository pattern or the DAO pattern to implement our persistence layer. Both of them separate the representation of the database record from the database operations. Frameworks like Spring Data JPA and Apache Data Spike support this by providing standardized repositories at runtime. When using the active record pattern, you avoid this separation and focus on the entity class and its objects. They represent records in the database, and their methods also encapsulate the database access. That follows the main ideas of the object-oriented programming paradigm. And as I will show you in this video, Panache handles most of the work so that you can concentrate on your business logic. When using the active record pattern, your entity classes need to provide methods for all supported database operations. This, of course, includes standard operations like find by ID, persist a new record, and update or remove an existing one. But it also includes all custom queries that return one or more objects of this class. Panache provides ready-to-use implementations of all standard operations and also helps you create custom queries. Let's get into the IDE and take a closer look at it. The easiest way to get all this is to extend the Panache entity class and define a public attribute for each database column you want to map. You don't need to implement any getter or setter methods, and you don't need to provide an identifier. Panache handles all of that for you. But you might need to add a few mapping annotations to define associations or activate optimistic locking. You can apply these annotations directly to the public entity attribute. Here you can see an example of an entity class that maps the records in the chess player table and supports standard database operations on that table. The Panache entity class provides multiple versions of find by ID, find, find all, list, list all, stream, stream all, and count methods, which you can use to read data from the database. We will take a closer look at some of these methods in a few seconds. And the Panache entity class also provides multiple persist, update, and delete methods. Please keep in mind that changes on managed entity objects are detected automatically and that you don't need to call any method to trigger a database update. Here you can see an example of a simple test case that creates a new chess player object, sets its attributes, and calls its persist method to store a new record in the database. When you execute this test case, you can see in the log output that Panache called the persist method on the entity manager. Hibernate then used the database sequence Hibernate sequence to get a new primary key value and executed an SQL insert statement. I mentioned earlier that you don't need to implement any getter or setter methods for your entity attributes. It internally rewrites read operations, for example, chessplayer.firstname, to calls of the corresponding getter method and write operation to calls of the corresponding setter methods. This ensures proper encapsulation and enables you to provide your own getter and setter methods if needed. I use that in the example here to implement a setLastName method that converts the provided last name to uppercase and prints out a message. When I rerun the test persist test case we used in the previous example, You can see that message in the doc output. As you saw in the previous section, the Panache entity class defines an ID attribute and uses the database-specific default strategy to generate unique primary key values. If you want to adjust that, for example, to use a different database sequence, your entity class needs to extend the Panache entity base class. This class doesn't define an identifying attribute. That's the only difference to the previously used Panache entity. When you extend the Panache entity base class, you need to include an identifier in your entity mappings, and you can choose a strategy and provide your own generator. The Panache entity and Panache entity base classes provide a set of methods to get an entity by its primary key, get all entities, and get one or more entities that fulfill specific criteria. You can use them to define your own queries comfortably. Let's take a closer look at the last group of methods before we end this video. You can call the find, list, and stream method with a query string and one or more bind parameter values. Panache will include your query string in the generated statement and set the provided bind parameter values. You can use this to define custom queries that return the data required by your use case. These methods are public. You could, of course, use them directly in your business code. But I recommend adding static methods to your entity class to separate your database operations from your business code. Within these methods, you can call the find, list, and stream method provided by the Panache entity base class. The interesting part of that method call is the provided query string. You can either provide a JPQL or HQL statement or a simplified HQL string. The simplified HQL string is only a small part of a query statement, and Panache generates the remaining parts. You can call these methods with an order by clause as simplified HQL, for example, order by date desk. Panache extends this to, from chess game, order by date desk, and executes the query. You can reference a single entity attribute by its name and provide one bind parameter value, for example, date and local date now. Panache extends this to from chess game where date equals a bind parameter and sets local date now as the bind parameter value. You can provide an entire where clause as the query string and the required bind parameters, for example, date equals bind parameter 1 and round equals bind parameter 2. Or if you prefer using named bind parameters, as I do, you can provide a map with bind parameter values. Panache extends these simplified statements to from chess game where date equals bind parameter 1 and round equals bind parameter 2, or from chess game where date equals the bind parameter date and round equals the bind parameter round, and sets the bind parameter values. Because SQL only supports positional bind parameters, Hibernate executes the same SQL statement for both HQL statements. When implementing the active record pattern, an entity class maps a database table and encapsulates the operations that you can perform on that table. This is an interesting alternative to the more popular repository and DAO patterns. The active record pattern aligns much better with the general ideas and concepts of object-oriented programming. I hope developers will use it more often in the future. As I showed you in this video, Panache helps you implement this pattern. It provides methods to find all records, find one record by its primary key, and persist, update, or remove a database record. In addition to that, Panache also generates getter and setter methods for your entity attributes, and you can use simplified HQL statements to define custom queries. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free member library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like cheat sheets and ebooks about using native queries with JPA and Hibernate. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. And if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!